Please remain standing for the national anthem. 奏国歌，请肃立。 The Dean of College of Business, Professor Frank Chen, is presiding. 主禮人商學院院長陳友華教授.
I declare this graduation ceremony open.
Please take your seat. 請就座. May I now invite the Dean of College of Business, Professor Frank Chen, to deliver his address. 請商學院院長陳友華教授致辭.
Good morning to you all. Congratulations to the 2019 and 2020 graduates of the College of Business. Graduation is a big achievement under any circumstances, but yours came as the world was turned upside down. I know it's been really challenging for you all since the summer of 2019 through to now. First, social unrest, and then the pandemic, which is still spreading. For 1920 graduates, we postponed your graduation ceremony in the hope that we would gather in person. That hasn't proved possible. So today, I speak to both cohorts, 2019s and 2020s. However, I want you to remember that a graduation ceremony doesn't celebrate just a point in time. It is a completion of all your years of learning, what you have learned about the world and about yourself over the years with us. Also, to remember that this is not just about you. Although you have worked very hard to successfully complete university and earn your degree with us today, you wouldn't have achieved it without the help of your families. They have given everything to make you what you are today. So, before I say anything further, I would like to acknowledge their efforts now and thank them for the part they played in your success. In your time with us, many of you will have benefited from exposure to areas such as accounting, economics, finance, global business, information technology, management, marketing, operations, and statistics. Many of you have gained a global mindset through exchanges and overseas learning. Many of you have participated in education, training, competition, programs featuring blockchain societies, local and international banks. Many of you will have taken advantage of career talks and service. And as a graduate of CTU, you are part of a cohort of students with increasingly successful employment record against all odds. That's upside. The downside is that this terrible year of COVID has made things look bleak to people all over the world. Besides, it's fair to say that your generation is graduating into a world that faces more profound challenges than any generation in decades. Today, we are struggling with unparalleled global issues, such as massive inequality, political polarization, revolutions in biotech such as brain science, and infotech such as artificial intelligence, climate change, immigration, and terrorism. Most of you are in your early 20s, which means that what happens over the next 50 years is going to be very relevant to you. So, what's likely to happen in the next 50 years? Again, think about the question, what is likely to happen in the next 50 years? I have just started reading a book by Yuval Noah Harari entitled 21 Lessons for the 21st Century. I was attracted by the opening paragraph in its introduction, quote, "In a world flooded with irrelevant information, clarity is power. In theory, anybody can join the debate about the future of our mankind, but it is so hard to maintain a clear vision," unquote. The paragraph concludes, quote, "If the future of mankind is decided in your absence, because you are busy feeding and clothing your kids, you and they will not be exempt from the consequences. This is unfair, but who said history was fair?" Unquote. I'm not going to talk about the book in detail. In fact, Harari points out many problems, but raises more questions than answers. And I happen not to agree with many of his ideas. Nevertheless, I appreciate the author's good intention to encourage and stimulate further thinking. Nobody has got a crystal ball, including the author, who is a historian. But we should think now about what's likely to happen in the years to come, especially in the next 20 years, 10 to 20 years. To begin with, I would like to say the future is in technology. The combination of biotechnology and artificial intelligence may enable some people to be digitally enhanced, informing what being human means. So my first advice to you is watch the development of technology and try to become tech savvy in your job. Now I would like to give you with a few more quick pieces of advice for what they are worth. I have been through some high points and some low points in my life. And the one thing that's true about both is that they pass. Change is a constant. So I say, celebrate the good times, and when times get tough, remember that they won't last forever. Things will get better. This is my second advice to you. Quote, "Take courage and think positive," unquote. My third advice is that learning doesn't stop with your graduation. Never stop learning, and never stop learning how to learn. Most of you are working, looking for a job, or studying for another degree, but eventually you'll be working. When you get to work, get proactive. So my fourth advice is be a problem solver. My last piece of advice is to listen to one another and build communities responsibly. Since the invention of the smartphone, it is clear that shopping, video, opinion, and communities are all moving predominantly online. There are many positive aspects to it. It's easy to find like-minded people, make friends, and work towards worthy causes. But reading like-minded news and opinions also reinforces our own prejudices. Then we can cancel out everything else that we don't like. So I suggest, look around. Don't get stuck with one point of view. Be open-minded. That's it. I would like to express my thanks to you for being part of our CB story. It's been a privilege working with you, and would like to take this opportunity to wish you every success in the future, but we want to stay in touch with you as well. More than ever, our alumni are lifeblood. And you, our alumni-to-be, are a significant means by which we refresh ourselves and stay up to date with current practices. So I extend a hand to you all with the hope that you will enjoy a role as active alumni, that you will take up opportunities to contribute to the education of the coming generations, and that you will revisit us at earliest opportunities. Thank you.
We are proud to present our graduates of 2019. 介紹 2019年度畢業生 Professor Wang Weiquan, Associate Dean, Research and Faculty of College of Business, 商學院副院長王偉全教授
Doctor of Philosophy, Master of Philosophy.
Professor Muema Oser, Director of DBA Program, 商學院工商管理博士課程主任歐澤賢教授.
Doctor of Business Administration.
Professor Yang Haibin, Director of IDBA Program, 商學院工商管理博士課程主任楊海斌教授.
Doctor of Business Administration.
Professor Kevin Zhang, Director of MBA Program, 商學院工商管理碩士課程主任江偉宇教授.
Master of Business Administration.
Dr. Michael Wong, Director of EMBA Program, 商學院行政人員工商管理碩士課程主任王澤森博士.
Master of Business Administration Executive.
Dr. Wang Yong, Associate Director of EMBA Chinese Program, 商學院行政人員工商管理碩士中文課程副主任汪勇博士.
Master of Business Administration Executive.
Professor Kim Chong-Pong, Head of Departments of Accountancy. 商學院會計學系系主任, 金正本教授.
Master of Art, International Accounting. 마스터 오브 사이언스, 프로페셔널 어카운팅 앤 코퍼레이트 가버넌스. 배추럴 오브 비즈니스 어드미니스트레이션 인 어카운턴시.
프로페서 마 유에, Head of Departments of Economics and Finance, 商學院 經濟及金融系系主任 마 유 教授.
Master of Science in Applied Economics. Master of Science in Finance. Master of Science in Financial Engineering. Master of Science in Financial Services. Bachelor of Business Administration in Banking and Financial Services. Bachelor of Business Administration in Business Economics. Bachelor of Business Administration in Finance.
Professor Fang Yulin, Acting Head of Department of Information Systems. 商學院資訊系統學系處理系主任方玉倫教授.
Master of Science in Business Information System. Thank you. Master of Science, Electronic Business and Knowledge Management. Master of Science, Information Systems Management. Bachelor of Business Administration in Global Business Systems Management. Bachelor of Business Administration in Information Management. Bachelor of Business Administration in Marketing Information Management.
Professor Jane Liu, Head of Departments of Management, 商學院管理學系系主任吕文珍教授。
Master of Arts in Global Business Management.Master of Science in Organizational Management. Bachelor of Business Administration in Human Resource Management. Bachelor of Business Administration in International Business. Bachelor of Business Administration in Management.
Professor Alan Wang, Head of Departments of Management Science, 商學院管理科學系系主任 温子堅教授。
Master of Arts in Quantitative Analysis for Business. Master of Science in Operations and Supply Chain Management. Bachelor of Business Administration in Business Analysis. Bachelor of Business Administration in Business Operations Management.
Professor David Lee, Head of Department of Marketing, 商學院市場營銷學系系主任 李燕智教授。
Master of Science in Marketing. Thank you. Bachelor of Business Administration in China Business. Bachelor of Business Administration in Marketing.
May I now invite the Associate Dean, Research and Faculty of College of Business, Professor Wang Weiquan, to introduce the 2019 Assurance of Learning Award. 请商学院副院长王伟全教授介绍2019年度课程提升及学习成效保证奖。
Professor Chen, it is the college's vision to nurture students to become innovative, insightful, ethical leaders and entrepreneurs by offering globally oriented, thought-provoking business programs. To ensure that our curriculum stays at the forefront of business education and to ensure students' effective learning, the college established the AOL Learning Assurance of Learning Award earlier this year, aiming to recognize colleagues' outstanding effort in introducing high-quality teaching and learning approaches and making improvements to our courses and programs. Through a vigorous selection process, the selection panel has selected Dr. Alvin Liang for this college award in 2019. The selection panel commended Dr. Alvin Liang for taking a comprehensive approach to AOL assessment, from implementation of the recommended actions and setting of assessment questions, to collection of AOL data and suggestions for further improvement. In Dr. Liang's course, CB2500, Information Management, we found plenty of compelling evidence to demonstrate that student learning in his course has been significantly enhanced. Professor Chen, may I invite you to present the Assurance of Learning Award to Dr. Alvin Liang in recognition of his outstanding effort in ensuring students' effective learning and promoting continuous curriculum improvement and innovation at the College of Business.
May I call upon Professor Frank Chan, Dean of College of Business, to present the 2019 Assurance of Learning Award. Dr. Liang is unable to attend the ceremony, and the award will be received by his representative, Professor Fang Yulin. 请商学院院长陈友华教授颁授2019年度课程提升及学习成效保证奖。梁博士是日未能出席典礼，奖项将由方玉伦教授代领。 May I now invite the Associate Dean, Undergraduate Programs of College of Business, Professor Stephen Shum, to introduce the 2019 College Teaching Excellence Award. 请商学院副院长岑云亨教授介绍2019年度学院杰出教学奖。
Professor Chen, please allow me to introduce to the congregation the College Teaching Excellence Award and the award winners for the year 2019. The College of Business is committed to fostering a culture of teaching excellence, as well as caring learning environment for our students. With the generous support of our EMBA alumna, Ms. Jenny Chan, the college established this Teaching Excellence Award in 2011 to recognize the very best teachers in the college. The College Teaching Excellence Award is presented annually through a vigorous selection process. Last year, the selection committee selected four colleagues for this prestigious award. They are Dr. Qian Qianhuan, Associate Professor of the Department of Economics and Finance, Dr. Zachary Leung, Assistant Professor of the Department of Management Sciences, Professor Muammar Osa, Professor of the Department of Management, Professor Wayne Yu, Professor of the Departments of Accountancy and Economics and Finance. The selection committees commended that the award winners have demonstrated exemplary teaching practice and exhibited lively and experiential approaches to teaching. Allow me to read their citations for each of the award winners. The committee commended that Dr. Qian Qianhuan is an enthusiastic teacher who brings a variety of instructional strategies and methods to the classroom. She is sensitive to students' needs and offers timely academic advice and guidance to the students for their personal and professional development. Professor Chan, may I invite you to present the College Teaching Excellence Award to Dr. Qian Qianhuan to recognize her outstanding teaching approaches and practice.
May I call upon Professor Frank Chan, Dean of College of Business, to present the 2019 College Teaching Excellence Award to the first awardee, Dr. Huang Qianqian. 请商学院院长陈乃华教授颁授2019年度学院杰出教学奖与第一位得奖者王善善博士。
The next colleague to be presented for the award is Dr. Zachary Leung. Dr. Leung is a devoted teacher and coach who prepares students for open business competitions with impressive results. He has been innovative for translating and repackaging the training contents into a formal course which develops students' case analysis skills in business. Professor Chan, may I invite you to present the College Teaching Excellence Award to Dr. Zachary Leung in recognition of his outstanding teaching approaches and practice.
May I call upon Professor Frank Chan, Dean of College of Business, to present the 2019 College Teaching Excellence Award to the second awardee, Dr. Zachary Leung. 请商学院院长陈乃华教授颁授2019年度学院杰出教学奖与第二位得奖者梁毅恒博士。
The next awardee for the College Teaching Excellence Award, Professor Muammar Osa. Professor Osa is a dedicated teacher who is always fully prepared for his classes, teaches with vigor and insights, and transforms students to the next level through discovery quests and reflective practice underpinned by clear teaching philosophy. As the DBA program director, he plays a leading role in renewing and reforming the DBA curriculum, as well as providing personalized advice and guidance to his students. Professor Chan, may I invite you to present the College Teaching Excellence Award to Professor Muammar Osa in recognition of his outstanding teaching approaches and practice.
May I call upon Professor Frank Chan, Dean of College of Business, to present the 2019 College Teaching Excellence Award to the third awardee, Professor Muammar Osa. 请商学院院长陈乃华教授颁授2019年度学院杰出教学奖与第三位得奖者欧泽贤教授。
Thank you. Last but not least, may I present Professor Wayne Yu to the congregation for the College Teaching Excellence Award. Professor Yu is an inspiring teacher who is able to create an interesting and interactive learning environment to spark students' interest and critical thinking. His teaching is well recognized by students of various levels, from undergraduate to postgraduate and executive education. He has contributed to new course development, revealing the advancement of knowledge in his discipline. Professor Chen, may I invite you to present the College Teaching Excellence Award to Professor Wing Yu to recognize his outstanding teaching approaches and practice.
May I call upon Professor Frank Chen, Dean of College of Business, to present the 2019 College Teaching Excellence Award to the fourth awardee, Professor Wing Yu. 请商学院院长陈友华教授颁授 2019 年度杰出教学奖予第四位得奖者 余伟峰教授。 The 2019 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award will now be presented. This award aims to recognize the outstanding achievements and contributions of our distinguished alumni to their professions, to universities and society. 现在颁发2019年度商学院杰出校友奖，此奖项表彰商学院校友在其专业、大学和社会领域的卓越成就和贡献。 May I now invite the Head of Department of Management Science of College of Business, Professor Alan Wang, to introduce the first awardee of the 2019 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award, Mr. Wilson Chong Aikin. 请商学院管理科学系系主任温子坚教授介绍 2019 年度商学院杰出校友第一位得奖者 庄毅坚先生。
Professor Chan, it is my pleasure to introduce to you Mr. Wilson Chong Aikin, who graduated with a BA in Quantitative Analysis for Business in 1992. For the past 20 years, Mr. Chong has been working in the mobile telecom industry. He's the Managing Director of Whitelink Technology Limited, a company that specializes in the design, R&D, production, and sales of mobile phones and tablet products. This company has engaged in many IoT applications, as well as big data and AI projects. In 2016, Mr. Chong established the IoT Hong Kong Association, which, among other things, promotes the exchange of IoT applications and the sharing of IoT technology between China and Taiwan. Mr. Chong hosts consultant or honorary positions in nine organizations. He's also a mentor of the College of Business Young Scholars Program and City U's KTO Innopreneurship Mentoring Scheme. Professor Chan, may I now invite you to present the 2019 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award to Mr. Wilson Chong to recognize his remarkable achievements and contributions.
May I call upon Professor Frank Chen, Dean of College of Business, to present the 2019 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award. 请商学院院长陈友华教授颁授 2019 年度商学院杰出校友奖。 May I now invite the Director of DBA Program of College of Business, Professor Muema Osa, to introduce the second awardee of the 2019 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award, Dr. Cham Ka Leong. 请商学院工商管理博士课程主任欧泽贤教授介绍 2019 年度商学院杰出校友奖予第二位得奖者湛家阳博士。
Professor Chen, Dr. Toa Cham graduated from our Doctor of Business Administration program in 2014. He is the chairman of OpenCert Hub and principal advisor to elite AI, big data, fintech, and e-commerce startups throughout Asia. He has over 20 years of management, entrepreneurship, consulting, and executive education experience in the innovation and technology industry. Dr. Charm has held senior management positions in leading multinationals, as well as Hong Kong and mainland enterprises such as Cyberport, HSBC, IBM, Oracle, King D, and Jardine Pacific. He specializes in AI, big data, fintech, innovation and entrepreneurship, digital strategy and transformation. He has contributed to both enterprises and startups throughout his career. He has empowered enterprises in transforming to the digital economy and cultivated more than 1,000 startups, of which 3 are now unicorns. Dr. Charm is also an associate professor of practice in management at the Chinese University of Hong Kong, where he nurtures digital talents and cultivates the next generation of digital leaders. Professor Chen, may I now invite you to present the 2019 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award to Dr. Tua Charm to recognize his outstanding achievements and contributions.
May I call upon Professor Frank Chen, Dean of College of Business, to present the College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award. 请商学院院长陈友华教授颁授2019年度商学院杰出校友奖。May I now invite the head of the Department of Management of College of Business, Professor Jane Liu, to introduce the third awardee of the 2019 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award, Professor Anthea Zhang Yan. 请商学院管理学系主任吕文珍教授介绍2019年度商学院杰出校友奖与第三位得奖者张燕教授。
It is my pleasure to introduce Professor Anthea Zhang,who's a Fierce Seraphine Vanguard Professor of Management in the Jones Graduate School of Business, Rice University. Her research has focused on CEO succession and corporate governance of public listed companies and foreign direct investment and technological entrepreneurship in emerging markets, notably China. Her research has been published in top academic journals,such as Academy Management Journal, Strategic Management Journal, Journal of Marketing Research, Journal of Marketing, and Journal of International Business Studies. Her research has been widely cited in top business media outlets, such as Harvard Business Review, Economist, Business Week, New York Times, Wall Street Journal, Washington Post, USA Today, and Financial Times.She has served as an associate editor of Academy of Management Journal and is an associate editor of Strategic Management Journal. She also served on the boards of directors of Strategic Management Society and International Corporate Governance Society. May I invite Professor Chen to present the award to Professor Anthea Zhang?
May I call upon Professor Frank Chan, Dean of College of Business, to present the 2019 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award. Professor Zhang is unable to attend the ceremony, and the award will be received by her representative, Professor Jane Liu. 请商学院院长陈友华教授颁授2019年度商学院杰出校友奖。张教授是日未能出席典礼，奖项由吕文珍教授代领。May I now invite our graduate representative, Jobs Kitkins, to say a few words on behalf of our graduating class of 2019. 请2019年度毕业生代表 Jobs Kitkins 致辞。
Honored Dean and professors, dear fellow graduates, family, friends, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Jobs Kitkins. I'm a graduate of the MBA program of 2019 at the City University of Hong Kong.It is my honor to be here representing all the graduates of 2019 and 2020 and to deliver you this graduation speech. Although it has to be a virtual graduation ceremony this year, it is certainly nice to be able to connect with everyone back in Hong Kong again. And I'm really grateful for this opportunity. Looking back at 2018, when Corona was still a drink, I made the decision to pursue my MBA at the City University of Hong Kong. This definitely hasn't been an easy decision since I had to leave everything behind in the Netherlands. And it was quite a big step for me to move all the way to Hong Kong. But already since day one, CityU and the MBA faculty has felt like one great family. And everyone has been really friendly, helping me getting around and getting accustomed to this new location. My studies at the CityU MBA have been an amazing journey. All the people that I've met, the companies we got to visit, the countries we visited, and the opportunities that are created by the MBA office have been immensely valuable. Looking back, all the hours we spent in the case room, all the evenings that we spent studying and having lectures, reading up on business and getting to know the business ethics and the culture in Asia have been quite an amazing learning experience for me. Today is the first day we get to pick the fruit of our labor and a symbol that finally all our hard work, dedication and diligence is paying off. This is a great moment to reflect on all the effort we put in the program, and I want to congratulate all my fellow graduates on receiving their academic rewards. This is also a great opportunity to thank all the people that supported us throughout this journey, such as our parents, our families, our loved ones, and our sponsors, who were always there in the time of need. I wish, therefore, that we also may grow in our careers and personal lives, so that when those we hold dear are in need of our help, we can come to their aid. Behind all the hard work that we put in during our studies, our loved ones have sacrificed a lot during these times, in terms especially of the time spent studying, whilst also continuing work, or having a family on the side or a business can be quite stressful. I especially want to thank all the professors for teaching us really valuable lessons in their respective professions. And I want to thank all the MBA faculty for drilling us hard during the program and always pushing us to perform better. Even if it meant that we had to switch our entire project the evening before, they always tried to maximize our results and always push us to just perform a little bit better than the days we did before. So altogether, I think I can speak for all the students that we should be extra thankful for having this opportunity to enjoy this educational resource that CityU has provided to us. We had the privilege to take our studies while others might have to live with poverty, disease, or having more difficult times during this pandemic. I understand that a high proportion of our recent graduates hold a significant leadership role in business, either right after the graduation ceremony or in the coming years. I think we should take that opportunity to dedicate ourselves to a better cause. It is our responsibility to give something back by doing good and providing opportunities to others like we had the same opportunity provided to us. And last but not least, I hope that we all find our ways in our careers and our personal lives. And I believe our study experience at the City University of Hong Kong has enriched our lives massively. It can only help us make this world we live in a better place. So all in all, I wish we get to see each other again soon in person. And for the time now, I want to congratulate everyone on graduating this year and all the best to you in your career. Thank you.
We are proud to present our graduates of 2020, 介紹2020年度畢業生。Professor Wang Weiquan, Associate Dean, Research and Faculty of College of Business. 商學院副院長王偉全教授。
Doctor of Philosophy. Master of Philosophy.
Professor Muema Osa, Director of DBA Program, 商學院工商管理博士課程主任歐澤賢教授。
Doctor of Business Administration.
Professor Yang Haibin, Director of IDBA Program, 商學院工商管理博士課程主任楊海斌教授,
Doctor of Business Administration.
Professor Kevin Zhang, Director of MBA Program, 商學院工商管理碩士課程主任江偉宇教授,
Master of Business Administration.
Dr. Michael Wong, Director of EMBA Program, 商學院行政人員工商管理碩士課程主任王澤森博士,
Master of Business Administration Executive.
Dr. Wang Yong, Associate Director of EMBA Chinese Program, 商學院行政人員工商管理碩士中文課程副主任汪勇博士,
Master of Business Administration Executive.
Professor Stephen Shum, Associate Dean, Undergraduate Programs of College of Business, 商學院副院長岑雲亨教授,
Bachelor of Business Administration in Global Business. Bachelor of Science in Computational Finance.
Professor Kim Chong Pong, Head of Departments of Accountancy, 商學院會計學系系主任金正管教授,
Master of Art in International Accounting. Master of Science in Professional Accounting and Corporate Governance. Bachelor of Business Administration in Accountancy.
Professor Ma Yue, Head of Departments of Economics and Finance, 商學院經濟及金融學系系主任 馬若教授。
Master of Science in Applied Economics. Master of Science in Finance. Master of Science in Financial Engineering. Bachelor of Business Administration in Banking and Financial Services. Bachelor of Business Administration in Business Economics. Bachelor of Business Administration in Finance.
Professor Fang Yulin, Acting Head of Department of Information Systems, 商學院資訊系統學系處理系主任 Fong Yulin 教授,
Master of Science, Business Information Systems. Master of Science, Electronic Business and Knowledge Management. Master of Science, Information Systems Management. Bachelor of Business Administration in Global Business Systems Management. Bachelor of Business Administration in Information Management. Professor Jane Liu, Head of Departments of Management, 商學院管理學系系主任呂文珍教授.
Master of Arts in Global Business Management. Master of Science in Organizational Management. Bachelor of Business Administration in Human Resource Management. Bachelor of Business Administration in International Business. Bachelor of Business Administration in Management.
Professor Alan Wang, Head of Departments of Management Science, 商學院管理科學系系主任温子堅教授.
Master of Arts in Quantitative Analysis for Business. Master of Science in Operations and Supply Chain Management. Thank you. Master of Science in Quantitative Analysis for Business. Bachelor of Business Administration in Business Analysis. Bachelor of Business Administration in Business Operations Management.
Professor David Lee, Head of Departments of Marketing. 商學院市場營銷學系系主任李彦智教授。
Master of Science in Marketing. Bachelor of Business Administration in China Business. Bachelor of Business Administration in Marketing.
May I now invite the Associate Dean, Research and Faculty of College of Business, Professor Wang Weiquan to introduce the 2020 College Teaching Excellence Award. 请商学院副院长王伟全教授介绍 2020 年度学院杰出教学奖。
Professor Chen, please allow me to introduce to the congregation the College Teaching Excellence Award winners for the year 2020. The selection committee has undergone a very careful selection process and decided that this prestigious award be given to Professor Steven Xiang from the Department of Management Sciences in recognition of his exemplary teaching practice and contributions to the curriculum development. Professor Xiang is a caring and a dedicated teacher who makes impact on students' lives. Apart from developing students' intellectual ability, Professor Xiang pays due attention to enhance students' skills and attitudes. By applying a new teaching paradigm, namely the content and language integrated learning, in collaboration with the English Learning Center, he helps students to build their presentation and case analysis skills at the same time. As a program leader, Professor Shem is sensitive to students' needs. He has contributed to curriculum development and designed various learning enrichment and career preparation activities for students' personal and professional development. These include a number of online workshops, courses, and activities to ensure that students continue to gain high-quality learning and developmental experience during the COVID-19 outbreak. Professor Chen, may I invite you to present the College Teaching Excellence Award to Professor Steven Xiang to recognize his outstanding teaching approaches and practice. Thank you.
May I call upon Professor Frank Chan, Dean of College of Business, to present the 2020 College Teaching Excellence Award to the awardee, Professor Steven Shum. 请商学院院长陈友华教授颁授 2020 年度学院杰出教学奖，与得奖者岑运亨教授。 The 2020 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award will now be presented. This award aims to recognize the outstanding achievements and contributions of our distinguished alumni to their professions, the universities, and society. 现在颁发 2020 年度商学院杰出校友奖，此奖项表彰商学院校友在其专业、大学和社会领域的卓越成就和贡献。 May I now invite the Head of Departments of Management Science of College of Business, Professor Alan Wang, to introduce the first awardee of the 2020 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award, Mr. William Peng Yuhua. 请商学院管理科学系主任温子坚教授介绍 2020 年度商学院杰出校长第一位得奖者彭宇华先生。
Professor Chan, I'm delighted to introduce to you Mr. William Peng Yuhua, who graduated with a BBA in Service Operations Management in 2008. Mr. Peng is the Vice President of Credit Suisse AG. He's a certified anti-money laundering specialist and a Hong Kong Institute of Bankers certified anti-money laundering professional. Mr. Peng has represented Credit Suisse for the Basel Committee. He was also a core member for his organization in a large-scale IPO that launched Hong Kong's first direct share purchase program in 2014. In addition, Mr. Peng won the Asia-Pacific Regional Excellence Award of Credit Suisse in 2014 and was Credit Suisse Asia-Pacific Regional Category winner for accountability in 2017. Mr. Peng has played an active role in mentoring students of the university. He has also recently become an external member of the Department of Management Sciences Departmental Advisory Committee. Professor Chan, may I now invite you to present the 2020 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award to Mr. William Pang to recognize his outstanding achievements and contributions.
May I call upon Professor Frank Chan, Dean of College of Business, to present the 2020 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award. 请商学院院长陈友华教授颁授2020年度商学院杰出校友奖。 May I now invite the Head of Department of Marketing of College of Business, Professor David Lee, to introduce the second awardee of the 2020 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award, Ms. Paula Yang Xiu-Yi. 请商学院市场营销学系主任李燕智教授介绍2020年度商学院杰出校友奖第二位得奖者杨小仪女士。
Mrs. Paula Yang, first enrolled at City Polytechnic in 1993 and graduated in 1996, the last year of the Bachelor of Arts in Business Studies at City University of Hong Kong. Mrs. Yang began her career as a media executive with FCB Hong Kong. She then joined PCCW IMS in 1999, taking part in the first generation of digital business players in Hong Kong. Paula sharpened her digital knowledge and experience through roles as Chief Business Manager of On.cc, a so-called Dongmong, Digital Head of Denso Media Hong Kong, and the General Manager of NDN Group. Mrs. Yang shares the same thriving spirit as CDU and was named Digital Marketer of the Year 2018 by the Hong Kong Association of Interactive Marketing. Over the years, she has been consistently supportive of our student development in many roles, including advising, mentoring, talks, and experience sharing. Professor Chen, now may I invite you to present the 2020 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award to Mrs. Paula Yang to recognize her outstanding achievements and contributions.
I call upon Professor Frank Chen, Dean of College of Business, to present the 2020 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award. 请商学院院长陈友华教授颁授2020年度商学院杰出校友奖。 May I now invite the Director of the MBA Program of College of Business, Dr. Michael Wong, to introduce the third awardee of the 2020 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award, Ms. Susanna Shen. 请商学院行政人员工商管理硕士课程主任黄泽森博士介绍2020年度商学院杰出校友奖第三位得奖者孙淑贞女士。
Ms. Susanna Shen, our EMBA graduate in 2004 and also a professional engineer, is a general manager of corporate IT at Hong Kong and China Gas Company Limited. It is generally known as Tang Gas. She is also chairperson of the CIO board of the Hong Kong Computer Society. Ms. Shen has over 30 years' experience in information technology. She has held several senior management positions after having joined the Tang Gas. She has had the Tang Gas IT department since 2005 and has been the forerunner in the adoption of advanced technology. She has won various awards during her career tenure, including the Hong Kong CIO Award in 2017 for large enterprises, and in 2002 was recognized by IBM as one of the 35 global women leaders in artificial intelligence. The IT team under Susanna's leadership is responsible for providing TangGas Group's IT services and solutions to support the business mission of TangGas and its subsidiary, as well as in mainland China business. Susanna served on several advisory committees in the public sector and also on various advisory panels, university and professional bodies. She has been the chairperson of CIO Board of Hong Kong Computer Society since 2017. Professor Chen, may I now invite you to present the 2020 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award to Ms. Susanna Shen to recognize her outstanding achievement and contribution.
May I call upon Professor Frank Chen, Dean of College of Business, to present the 2020 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award. 请商学院院长陈友华教授颁授2020年度商学院杰出校友奖。May I now invite the Director of DBA Program of College of Business, Professor Murama Osa, to introduce the fourth awardee of the 2020 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award, Dr. Claudio Chen Xiuping. 请商学院工商管理博士课程主任欧泽贤教授介绍2020年度商学院杰出校友奖第四位得奖者陈少平博士。
Professor Chen, I'm happy to introduce Dr. Claudio Chen for the Distinguished Alumni Award for this year. Dr. Claudio Chen is Head of Investment at Bank of China Hong Kong, overseeing the bank's global investment strategy and liquidity management. His banking career spans over three decades. Previously, he worked as Head of Treasury for Citibank Hong Kong. Dr. Chen was a key member of the Treasury Market Association, and the offshore RMB market was developed under his leadership role at the association. Over the years, he has provided extensive services to the community, serving, among many things, as deputy chairman, executive board member of the Treasury Market Association, Chairman of the Market Practices Committee of the Treasury Markets Association, and Chairman of the Market Standard Committee under the Hong Kong Association of Banks. Dr. Chen graduated from our DBA program in 2019. Professor Chen, may I please invite you to present the 2020 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award to Dr. Claudio Chen to recognize his outstanding achievements and contributions.
May I call upon Professor Frank Chen, Dean of College of Business, to present the 2020 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award. 请商学院院长陈友华教授颁授2020年度商学院杰出校友奖。May I now invite the Director of IDBA Program of College of Business, Professor Yang Haibing, to introduce the fifth awardee of the 2020 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award, Dr. Yan Shengjun. 请商学院工商管理博士课程主任杨海斌教授介绍2020年度商学院杰出校长第五位得奖者严胜军博士。
Dr. Yan Shengjun, founder of China Tianyin Incorporation, CNTY,graduated from City University of Hong Kong in 2016 and was recently named as 2020 China Economic News Person, 2020 中国经济新闻人物. Since the establishment of CNTY in 1996, Dr. Yan has been deeply committed to the environmental production industry, and today CNTY is the world's fourth largest company in the industry.In response to China's Belt and Road Initiative, Dr. Yan has worked at integrating resources on a global level, attaching great importance to green development and building a state-of-the-art industrial ecosystem. Under Dr. Yan's leadership, since COVID-19 struck, CNTY has donated large quantities of personal protection equipment and funds, fulfilling corporate social responsibilities. Dr. Yan has taken upvarious roles to support the industry and the wider society, including contributions to the university. Professor Chen, may I now invite you to present the 2020 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award to Dr. Yan Shengjun to recognize his outstanding achievements and contributions.
May I call upon Professor Frank Chan, Dean of College of Business, to present the 2020 College of Business Distinguished Alumni Award. Dr. Yan is unable to attend the ceremony, and the award will be received by his representative, Professor Yang Haibing. 请商学院院长陈友华教授颁授2020年度商学院杰出校友奖，严博士是日未能出席典礼，奖项由杨海滨教授代领。 May I now invite the Associate Dean, Research and Faculty of College of Business, Professor Wang Weiquan, to introduce CTU Outstanding Research Award 2020. 请商学院副院长王伟全教授介绍2020年度成大杰出研究奖。
Professor Chen, the CTU Outstanding Research Award Scheme rewards research excellence and emphasizes the university's commitment to creating an environment conducive to high-quality research. This year, our college has a winner for the award. Today, I have the greatest pleasure to introduce to the CTU Outstanding Research Award winner for the year 2020, Professor Kai Lim. Professor Lim is Yangqing Man Chair Professor in Information Technology Innovation and Management in the Department of Information Systems, IS. The IS department has been consistently ranked among the top five IS departments worldwide in terms of research published in top-tier journals. Professor Lim's research centers on the effects of the deployment and design of information technology on changing individual and organizational behavior. His research interests include cross-cultural issues related to IS management, IS-enabled digital innovation and management, and e-health. He is one of the most prolific scholars from the Asia-Pacific region in terms of the number of publications in the very top IS journals, MIS Quarterly and Information System Research. Professor Lim has been a key member of the editorial board for these IS journals, serving two terms as senior editor for MIS Quarterly, 2011 to 2016, and associate editor for Information System Research, 2007 to 2011, and MIS Quarterly, 2002 to 2005. Professor Lim has been an honorary professor at Fudan University since 2013, and at Wuhan University, 2012 to 2015. He was made a fellow of the Association for Information Systems in 2017 in recognition of his contributions to the IS community. Professor Chen, may I invite you to present the CTU Outstanding Research Award to Professor Kai Lim to recognize his outstanding research achievements.
May I call upon Professor Frank Chan, Dean of College of Business, to present the CTU Outstanding Research Award 2020 to the awardee Professor Lin Kai. 请商学院院长陈友华教授颁授2020年度成大杰出研究奖予得奖者林开教授。 May I now invite our graduate representative, Wong Chen Shen, to say a few words on behalf of our graduating class 2020. 请2020年度毕业生代表王俊星致辞。
Good afternoon, Dean, honorable guests, professors, parents, fellow graduates, ladies and gentlemen. I'm honored to speak to you on this very important day. My name is CS. I'm a graduate of the bachelor's degree in computational finance for this cohort. I'm very honored to be invited to be graduate speaker at the 2020 College of Business graduation ceremony, including the first ever cohort to do this online. And let me begin by expressing my warmest congratulations to the class of 2020. 4 years ago, we gathered in the auditorium in AC3 for orientations, or at least some of us did. 4 years ago, some of us did not know who we were, while others knew exactly who they were and the person they were working to be. 4 years down the line, a lot of that has changed. We have learned not just the requisite coursework, but also a lot about ourselves. We have unlearned, and we have survived countless days and nights, the assignments and finals that we once thought would be the reason that we were not able to graduate. But here we are today. It's truly a time to celebrate our remarkable journeys and achievement, the fruit of our hard work, commitment, and tenacity. Every end has a new beginning. Today might be the last day for most of us as students at the College of Business, but I believe it is only the beginning of a phase on our steep lifelong learning curve, with the next phase starting from today. Since we are part of the College of Business, I assume we have all learned about risk return reward. In other words, the higher the risk, the better reward for any risk taker. This concept is simple, yet applicable, not just in the field of finance, but to our everyday life. I consider myself a risk taker. When I left home 4 years back, leaving my family and friends behind and deciding to pursue my degree in CDU was not an easy decision. Coming alone and surviving in a whole new environment while facing the reality of being in the first batch of students for the computational finance major, I wasn't sure what I would get in return. Born and growing up in Malaysia, where the opportunity within the finance industry is limited, I decided to take the risk. Today, with modesty in mind, the fact that I attained first runner-up in the world's largest training competitions for 2 years consecutively, were able to graduate from CDU and achieve my dream job as a trader in the prop trading firms, I'm proud to say that I'm mom. I've made it. I hope that I made you guys proud and no one would ever look down on you guys again. Looking back, I'm glad that I made the right decisions to come to Hong Kong. Now, let us take a moment to thank all those people who have helped us behind the scenes to reach this momentous occasion. Thank you for always supporting us, for being there for us, for understanding when we had to study, even during weekends, instead of spending the valuable time with you. Personally speaking, it would have been impossible for me to reach where I am today without the unconditional love and support from both my parents and my girlfriend. Next, on behalf of all the graduates from CB, I'd like to sincerely thank our professors, mentors, faculty, and staff in CDU University of Hong Kong. Thank you for generously sharing your knowledge and experience with us, especially Professor Lee, the major leader of computational finance. Thank you for all the efforts in organizing talks and help us finding internship. And last but not least, I would like to thank my friends and peers. Thank you for all the support during the last few years. We each come from different backgrounds with different experience and skill sets, so studying together and learning from each other was an awesome experience that helped broaden our horizons. And outside of study, we share many memorable times, which will surely enrich our life in the years to come. It is very unfortunate that we're graduating at the worst timing possible, having not just facing the challenges caused by pandemic, but into the worst economy for decades. We all have definitely reached consensus that 2020 has been the worst year we have ever been through. No on-spot graduation ceremonies, no travels, entertainments limited, or some even have lost their jobs. Worse, the psychological despair so many of us are feeling is real. How much more can we take? We ask ourselves. Most of us would have hoped that 2020 can be erased from calendar and wish that it had never happened. So what? We should be proud of ourselves, not only being able to withstand the rampage of pandemic, but also able to complete our degree with countless obstacles in front of us. It was none other than us that survived this change of disaster and are still standing here. We're young and have nothing to lose. In fact, the world has made a pause for us and gave us time to take a deep breath, especially to those who are still lost and searching for the directions. This is, in fact, a blessing in disguise for all of us. Finally, I'd like to end my speech today with the one and only quote that I have been adhering to all my life. You only live once. If you live it right, once enough. So stay curious, stay hungry, and live life with belief and purpose. I wish for all the best in your future endeavors. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I declare this graduation ceremony closed.